Creating transaction types. So in this video, I'm going to take you through how to do that, and I'm going to show you how to then apply it into a transaction in your invoice module. So creating these transaction types is going to help you for when you're running reports going forward based on this information. So first of all, I'm just going to show you how to set up in our server preferences before we start to set up those transaction types. So going up to File in 4D and then down to your server preferences, you'll see on the general tab that we have some checkboxes on the right hand side. We want to make sure that the ask transaction type in invoice is checked. This is so when we go to actually do an invoice in a transaction, we actually have the field in order to type in what transaction type we're using. So let's go down and save these settings. And now let's create those transaction types. So you'll need to find the module in your dropdown that's labeled transaction types. And then once in here, you'll see by clicking on all, we don't actually have any created. So this is where we're going to actually create those right now. So on your toolbar, we click on new, and we need to create a code for the types of transactions that you want to put in. So let's say, for example, we're going to do a cash-to-cash transaction. And then we can click on save. Let's add a few others. Let's say we do a check cashing, so we can put in a code and then obviously check cashing afterwards. And let's just create a couple more. Maybe we want to do an EFT for domestic. So we can say domestic fund transfer. And then let's create one just for international as well. So we'll have EFT for international. So international fund transfer. And save. If you go onto your toolbar now and click on all, you'll see all of the ones we've just created. We've got a code associated with them as well as the name, the description, and the type. So now we've created these, I'm going to show you how to actually apply those into an invoice. So go to your invoice module, and we want to create a new invoice, so clicking on new on your toolbar. We can use this tool for walk-in customers as well as customers with profiles. So let's just have a walk-in customer, and then you'll see the field right underneath the customer ID is transaction code. So this is where we just created these codes, and now we can implement them into this invoice. So we can type in the code if you remember it. So we can say this was a cash to cash transaction. Hit tab and you'll see that it brings up the description cash to cash. Now you just treat the invoice as you would any other invoice, so we can just do a transaction as normal. So let's just do a transaction of euros. And then we can just save this invoice. So let me take you through another invoice and just show you that we have a walk-in customer and say you don't remember the transaction code. So let's say it was a check cashing that we want to do. So all you need to do is type in a word that is in that description. So we could put, let's put cash because that will bring up a couple for us. So you type in cash and you just hit tab. You'll see that it's going to bring up anything that we created with the word cash in it. So we've got cash to cash or we've got check cashing. So that's great because then we can select the one that we actually wanted. Let's say though that a type of transaction that we wanted didn't actually come up in this drop down because it hadn't been created yet. We don't need to go all the way back into transaction types module and create it there. We can do so right now on this page. Down at the bottom you'll see add new transaction type. Simply clicking here will bring you back to that same window that you saw when you were creating them at the beginning. And you can enter in that transaction code and create that type right here. So that's a very handy tool as well. But we're going to go with the check cashing. So you can either double click or we can click on pick. And then you would just simply go through your invoice as you would normal, your transaction as normal. So again, a very powerful tool that we can use for reporting purposes. So you can really run reports based on what transaction types you've done. And I will show you how to do those reporting how to run those reports in a future video, but just for now, this is how to set up those transaction codes and applying them into an invoice in a transaction.